And so today we'll be looking at effective preparation part one. That is the title of today's message. Effective what? Preparation part one. So when we talk about preparation, the word preparation is a noun. And then it is a derivative from the word prepare, which is a verb. Children, be quiet. Absolute silence. So the word preparation is what? Is a noun. I'm trying to do some English lessons here. Free English lessons for all of us. It's a noun. And then it is a derivative from the word what? Prepare. Amen. Please pay attention. Pay close attention. Today's message will bless you. Now, let's define the word prepare. What it means to what? To prepare. Like I said earlier, I said the word prepare is what? It's a verb. It means to make someone or something. Yeah? It means to make someone or something ready for some activity. That's for a particular activity, purpose, or use. Let me say it again. I said the word prepare is a verb. Yeah? Well, you know what a verb is? A verb is an action word. Yeah? When we say verb, we're talking about an action word. So when we say to prepare, it means to what? To actually to do something. Amen. Pay close attention, please. So the word prepare is a verb. It means to make someone or something ready for an activity, a purpose, or use. The word prepare also means to make ready or suitable or equip in advance for a particular purpose. I'll take it again from the top. As the word prepare is a verb, it means to make someone or something ready for a particular what? Activity, purpose, or use. It also means to make ready for suitable, okay, to make ready or suitable or equip in advance for a particular purpose. Praise the Lord. I will explain so that you will have a better understanding of what I'm saying. Now, before we can talk about preparation, there is something that precedes preparation. Amen? Please pay attention. Look up here. There is something that what precedes preparation. When I say something precedes preparation, I'm saying that there's something that comes before what? Preparation. Let me give you a vivid example. If you just say, maybe you're in your house and somebody meets you and say, what's happening? And you say, are they prepare? Are they waiting? Are they prepare? The next thing that will come to the person's, the next question that the person will ask is, waiting you they prepare for? So that means that there is something that comes before what? Preparation. There is an activity, there is a goal, there is a vision, there is an objective. You don't just prepare, am I correct? You are actually prepared for what? For something. So it could be that maybe you're preparing, maybe you want to prepare egusi soup. How many of us love egusi soup here? Okay, this one says he loves egusi soup. I do too. It's either you're preparing egusi soup, or you want to prepare egusi soup, or maybe you want to travel. Maybe you want to go to Nembe for a particular activity. Am I correct? So there's something that definitely always precedes preparation. Or maybe you're trying to prepare for an exam. Those of us that are students here, you write exams. Don't you prepare before you go and write the exams? If you don't prepare, what's going to happen to you? You fail. So they say proper preparation precedes performance. Excellent performance. Proper preparation precedes. That's when you say precedes, it means something that comes before another thing. So if you don't prepare in life, generally, this is the rule. If you don't prepare, then you will definitely, what will happen to you? You will most likely what? Fail. Anything you want to do, there's always preparation. If you want to prepare egusi soup in the house, is there no, what they call it? things you have to do. There are things you will have to do. Abi, women, what is the first thing you do? You go, you write a list. Some of you that write lists. Ugu, 20 naira. Is there ugu in egusi soup? Please, I don't know. Forgive me. Oil. There's ugu. Okay. Ugu, 100 naira. Maggi, 20 naira. I almost said beans. It's some, you know, ekpomo, shaki, all those ones. You write the list. Oil, water, abi. Then if you don't have fire, you go and look for firewood. Oil, kerosene, hell, there has to be fire in your house. Then after you finish that one, you do what? You go to the market. Am I correct? Then you go and buy those things, the condiments or the things for the recipe, the items you have listed out. Then you will come back. Then you start what? Preparing it, you understand? So there's a procedure. But you see, the goal, the vision is what? Is a goosey soup. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? So before you can talk about, before you start talking about preparation, you already have a goal. You already have an objective in your mind. There's something in your mind. You're picturing something. Am I correct? You are picturing something. You can't just say, I did prepare. Before you say, I did prepare, you have a what? You have a goal. How many of us have goals for the year 2021? You have a goal for 2021. Amen. Thank God you're in this service. So something is about to drop in this service, and I want you to catch it. So we cannot talk about preparation if we don't have that goal. We must have what? Please, somebody take care of that baby. We must have a goal. We must have what? A goal. There must be something that we're actually working towards when we talk about what? Preparation. Amen. Now, let me read this to you. Vision, goals. Listen to this. Vision, goals, objectives, outcome, purpose, end result come before what? Preparation. You sit down, you've thought about it. This year, 2021, I want to start a business. Maybe for some of us here, we want to start a business, maybe a personal business in 2021. Or maybe you want to be involved in personal development. Maybe you want to learn a skill in 2021. You want to learn a skill in 2021. You want to start a business in 2021. Whatever it is that your goal is, you already have it in your what? In your mind. It's already conceived. It's already preconceived. It's inside you what you want to do. Maybe some of us, maybe you want to buy a land this year. Maybe you want to start building your house this year. Maybe you want to get married this year. We all have what? Goals. We all have what? Objectives. We have what? End results. We have things in our mind that we want to what? Achieve in 2021. Am I correct? All right. So these things will determine how we would what? Prepare. Your goals, your objectives, those things you have set for yourself for the year 2021 will determine the kind of preparation, your level of what? Preparation. Amen. Is anybody getting anything? All right. So let me read this to you again. I said vision, goals, objectives, outcome, purpose, end result. These things precede preparation. I'll say that again. Vision, goals, objectives, outcomes, purpose, end result precede what? Preparation. In other words, an idea of the end is preconceived. Eh? An idea. You already have an idea of what the end would be like. There's a saying I got to know when I was in school back then in NDU. They used to say, I read a book one time, and the author said, throw your mind over the bar, and then your body will what? Follow. Throw your mind what? Over the bar, and then your body will follow. So before, let's just say you want to go to Port Harcourt. Your mind is already where? In Port Harcourt, but your body is here. So because you have conceived it in your mind, Say, I'm going to Port Harcourt. You've already seen yourself in Port Harcourt. All you need to do is just, you get up, you take your bath, you get your transportation ready, you pack your bags, you head to the park. You board the bus, and then you start going to Port Harcourt. But in your mind, you already said, you know, Port Harcourt, like there they go. So that's how it is in life. So for whatever, most people will tell you, and it is the truth, that whatever you see in life, everything you see around you is somebody's imagination. Somebody has sat down to think about it. And then the person now started walking towards it. And it is that walking towards that particular goal, that is what preparation is all about. When you've had something in your head and then you start walking towards it, it means you're what? Preparing what? Towards achieving that thing. Amen. Are you being blessed? Now, vision, goal setting. Vision is the same thing as goal setting. There's an imperative need to understand what we are preparing for. We must be able to understand what we are preparing for. You cannot just say, are they prepared? You must understand that thing. You must have that thing in your what? In your head and in your mind. You must have a mental image, an idea or a mental image, picture of something that you're what? You're trying to prepare for. Amen. Praise the Lord. It is my prayer that as we have started this year, we have written down our goals, our vision for the year 2021. It is my prayer that God will give us the empowerment and the enablement to be able to achieve those things in the name of Jesus. Now, let's look at one key scripture for today. We'll start looking at the scriptures one after the other. We have about 7 scriptures to look at. This message is a brief one anyway, but it's very powerful. Let's look at the first scripture, Habakkuk 2:2. It's a popular scripture. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2. It says what? It says, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Look at your neighbor and say, write the vision. Write the vision. It says, the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain on tables. That's on tablet. On a stone, on something, on a scroll. Write it. Write. It says, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain on tables, that he may read it. He may run that what? Readeth it. Take me to the other translation, the HSBC, I think. Put me on HSBC, let's see. Come on. Can you do that? Tech department. Okay, it says, the Lord answered me, write down the vision, clearly inscribe it on tablets, so one may easily what? Read it. So in other words, the first step towards achieving anything is when you've had it in you, when it is in you, it is not enough. You have to what? Sit down and what? Write it. Look at your neighbor and say, write it. So let me ask you a question today. Have you written your vision down for the year 2021? So if I should ask you now, would you be able to tell me? Have you written your vision for the year 2021? Is it written? So if you have not written your vision for this year, please do what? Write it. That's where it starts from. Step one, write it. Write it what? Down. So that when it begins to happen, you can say, okay, this one, God don't do it for me. So you what? You tick up. Very important. And all of us too in church, we should try and formulate the habit of what? Coming with what? Writing materials as well, so that we can write. Praise the Lord. And I also want to encourage us again, please subscribe to the church YouTube channel. It will bless your life. It will bless you tremendously. Praise the Lord. So the Lord answered me, said, write the vision. So it's not enough to have the vision in your head. You should be able to what? Put it down. This year, 2021, I want to buy one plot of land. You can even be very articulate, Seth. Maybe you can even say, okay, I want to buy one plot of land in Ogbogoro. Praise the Lord. So you can be that articulate. You write it down. This year, I want to marry. This year, I want to start a clothing business. So when you write your vision down like that, you can see it, and then it motivates you. Sometimes what I used to do when I was much younger, I could write it and then I could paste it somewhere in my house so that every morning I'll take a look at it. So that you know what you're pursuing. So when you see it, it motivates you. Am I correct? If you write something and you paste it somewhere and every morning you have to read that thing, you are motivated. Amen? That's the truth. You are motivated to do what? To achieve that thing. So this year we must... This year is just beginning. What's today's date? 3rd January, right? So if you have not written your vision down for the year, I want you to do what? Write it down. Maybe you buy a fresh, exercise book and you put it down there. And you look at it. And you write on top of it, say, my vision for the year 21. Let's read it one more time. Take me back to that scripture, Habakkuk 2:2. Let's read it one more time. We'll read it together. It says what? The Lord answered me, write down this vision, clearly inscribe it on tablets, so one may easily what? Read it. So you write it, and then you look at it, you thank God for it, you read it, you meditate on your, this is my vision for the year 2021. Because when you do that, you become articulate. You've been able to separate the chaff from the wheat. You understand? You know, okay, nobody can distract you. Some people, the year just begins, they don't have anything. They're just there. Anywhere the breeze blow them go, they don't go. Say this year, say, blessing an oil business we will do. Oil business. Oil business. Then somebody don't discuss that one with you. The next day, another person will come. Say this year, no, oil no go move market. Kerosene. Kerosene. I go, oh, kerosene. Yeah, kerosene. Okay. And that person will leave and go, say, this year, no, corn. Corn. They are just confusing you. But when you've written down your vision, if somebody comes to you and says, this year, na corn, now we'll go say, no, we'll go say, no, no. This year, God tell me, say, make I wait, sell with on. You understand? I'm just giving you an idea that you already know that, okay, this is what you want this year. So you have been able to separate what? The chaff from the wheat. You know where you are going. Do you know where you're going in 2021? If you know where you're going, let me see your hand. Do you know where you're going? Are you sure of where you're going? If I should give you this microphone now and say, tell me where you're going, are you sure you know? Okay. Pastor Joe, are you sure you know? Okay. Now let's look at one other scripture that talks about writing. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 1 to 3. Let's read it. Jeremiah 31. It says, this is the law. This is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Next verse. It says, this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Write down. Look at your neighbor and say, write down. Write down. Write down on a scroll all the words that I have spoken to you. Write down. This year we'll write. Oh. This year is a what? It's a writing year.
I hear you, sir.
It's a writing year. We'll write. And then as we are writing, God will be doing it. As you write them, God go they do them.
Amen.
So if you want God to do them, you go waiting, you go write them.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't write, get somebody to write for you. Tell the person, say, see waiting I want. I don't know how, but you now, you construct them with English. But this year, I want to build my skyscraper this year. Write them. Write. Write them. I want to buy my car with what? Air-conditioned chair and massaging chair. Massaging seats. Write them. And I tell you, as you begin to write it, God will begin to do it.
Amen.
Let's continue. It says, this is what the Lord, the God of Israel says. Write down on a scroll all the words that I have what? Spoken to you. Verse 3. For the days are certainly coming, this is the Lord's declaration, when I will what? Restore the fortunes of my people, Israel, and what? Judah, the Lord's declaration, I will restore them to the land I gave to their ancestors, and they will what? Possess it. This is what God was telling Jeremiah to write. This is what God was telling Jeremiah. He said, write them. So that when I do them, you say, you go waiting, you go see them. You go know. So go and write it though. That dream that God has given you for 2021, do what? Write it. If you don't write it, God is not going to do it. But if you write it, He will what? He will do it. Praise the Lord. Are you being blessed this morning? Okay, let's continue. Let's look at the next scripture. Romans chapter 15, verse 4. Romans what? 15, verse 4. Put it on the screen for me. Look at it. It says, for whatsoever was written before was written for our what? Instruction. So that through our endurance and through the encouragement of scriptures, we may what? Have hope. So when something is written, that particular thing can serve as what? Can serve as a reference. Huh? When it is written, you can always go back. You can refer to it. You can go back to it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Are you being blessed this morning? So, one of the things you have to do in 2021 is that you have to learn to be a good writer. A good what? An excellent writer. So if you don't know how to write now, begin to learn how to write. And write too. Keep writing. Write everything that comes to your head. Because God is in the business of what? Doing the miraculous this year, 2021, in this church. Amen. Whatever it is that you want, what? Write them. Praise the Lord. Now let's move on. Now, in order to prepare adequately, we must be able to see our way what clearly. In order to prepare adequately, we must be able to see our way what clearly. So you cannot prepare when you will not be able to prepare well when you've not been able to see your way clearly. When you've not been able to, you know, you don't know where you're going. You don't know what you want to achieve. Somebody, 2021, somebody will ask you a question. You can't give a definite answer. Then you will not be able to achieve anything. Let me read that to you again. I said, in order to prepare adequately, we must be able what? To see our way clearly. We must be able to do what? See our way what? Clearly. In order to prepare adequately, we must be able to see our way clearly. We should be able to articulate our visions accurately and in great detail. Let me take that again. We should be able, in 2021, you and I should be able to articulate our visions. That is, you should be able to say it, our visions accurately and in what? And in great detail. Let me ask you a question. What do you see in 2021? What do you what? What do you see? Look at your neighbor and say, what do you see? Look at the next person and say, what do you see? What do you see? Do you see poverty, sickness, and diseases, and troubles, and COVID-19? And lockdown and pandemic, or you see glory, you see jobs, you see houses, you see cars, you see lands. So what do you see? Let's look at one scripture, Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 11. We're moving, we'll soon round up. What do you see? Look at your neighbor one more time and say, what do you see? Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 11. Put it on the screen. Then the word of the Lord came to me asking, what do you what? See? What do you see? Jeremiah replied, I see a branch of an almond tree. Wow. When the word of the Lord came to him, he says, what do you see, Jeremiah? He didn't say, he'd be like, say, are they get one thing where they see, they look like, but I'm not sure what thing I see. But I see something, sure. That's how some of us are. Say, in 2021, what do you see? See, be like, say, this pan, this COVID-19, no go now. You in the next year, now you go. This Buhari government, now very bad government. I see them. Is that what you see? That's not what I see, oh. And because you are here, that's not what you are going to see. So I pray for everybody here that God should give you the empowerment and the enablement to what? To see what? Clearly. To see, you should be able to know where you are going. Say, where am I going this 2021? Say, I am going to Zion. Say, I see myself in my own house. I see myself driving my own car. You should be able to see clearly. It says, the word of the Lord came to me asking, what do you see, Jeremiah? Say, I replied. He was very articulate. He didn't guess. Look at your neighbor and say, in 2021, no guesswork. No guesswork. We are not going to guess. We know what God is about to do. And we will say it. Amen. Let's move on. We'll look at another scripture again. Amos chapter 7 verse 8. Amos chapter 7 verse 8. Look at your neighbor again and say, what do you see? What do you see? Look at this one again. He says, the Lord asked me, God talking to Amos. He says, what do you see, Amos? I replied, a plumb line. Then the Lord said, I am setting a plumb line among my people, Israel. I will no longer what? Spare them. Now, this is what I'm trying to say now. This is the message here. Anytime God is asking these people, says, what do you see? What do you see? They are always what? Accurate, they are articulate. It is my prayer that God will make all of us present here articulate in 2021. Amen. I don't like guesswork. There will be no guesswork this year at all. Say, Holy Spirit, no guesswork. No guesswork. I see my way clearly. I see my vision clearly. I see my way clearly. I see my end clearly. I see my 2021 clearly. Yes. Are you blessed? So we're talking about preparation. But we cannot prepare when we cannot see our way clearly. We can't. What are we preparing for? Say you somebody will not see you in your house. You want to cook. Say, what do you want to cook? Say, I'm not sure. This thing like this now, the way they go, feet be big now. I've been start saying our beans. But now, hi, wow, blessing our rice. Then you go come outside. Sure. You started cooking, you've bought things, but you don't know what you want to cook. So what do you want to cook? I know, sure. I don't know. Be like, ha. Not in 2021. Maybe it happened in 2020, but it's not going to happen in 2021. It's not going to be part and parcel of anybody here in the name of Jesus. We will see our way, what? Clearly. So that we can prepare. Because we cannot prepare when we cannot see. We're not going to prepare when we don't see. We must see well. Tell your neighbor, I see. I can see. Clearly. Let's read one more scripture. Let's go to Zechariah chapter 5 verse 2. Let's look at that one again. We're almost running up. I'm done. It says, read it. It says what? What do you see? What do you see? What do you see? Very soon, I'll give this mic to somebody in this congregation and ask the person, what do you see in 2021? He says, what do you see? He asked me. He says, I see a flying scroll. I replied, 30 feet. Do you know, one of the things I like about this particular scripture is that the guy, he was very what, he even gave the, you understand, the, the dimensions. He gave everything. He said, this is what I see. Say, so, Jerome, what do you see? Say, I see a Range Rover Jeep. 2019 model. With massaging seats. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? I'm articulate. I'm not just saying I see something, they move. You get four tire. I'm not sure. Like old 1987 504. Put your right hand on your chest. Say, I see.
I see.
I see.
I see.
Clearly. He says, what do you see? He asked me. I see a flying scroll. I replied, 30 feet long and 15 feet what? Wide. I see. No guesswork. This year we will see.
Amen.
Every member of Pillar of Truth will see.
Amen.
You will see, oh. Whether you like it or not. You will what?
See.
You will see. You will see, because seeing clearly precedes what? Effective preparation. It is when you see clearly, that is when you can what? Prepare effectively. That's when your preparation can be effective. So, what do you want to prepare? I want to prepare beans. You have seen it, that this is what you want to prepare. So, you what? You go for it. You know what? You must know what the end from what? From the beginning. How many of us know the end from the beginning for this year, 2021, in our personal lives? You've seen your end this year. Let me see you. So you've not seen your end, right? If you have not seen your end, I prophesy that you will see your end this 2021. Maybe you don't understand what I just said. They don't understand the English. They don't understand. Maybe they feel that I mean something negative. No, that's not what I mean. What I'm trying to talk about, I'm talking about the positive. I'm saying that how many of you have been able to see that desired end where you want to be at the end of 2021? You have it in your head. You have it in your mind. That's what I mean. And I say it again. If you don't, I pray for you that God will empower you and give you the enablement to be able to see what your end in 2021. And most importantly, everyone that is under the sound of my voice will end 2021 in greater glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We'll end well. Every member of Pillar 2 will end. From this least to the greatest, all of us will end this year well. January is our month of preparation. And this is just part one of the message. Next week, we'll look at another one. Look at part two of this message. In conclusion, let's look at Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. I'm done. Are you blessed? Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. This is my concluding scripture. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. It says, Proverbs. This is 3 John 1, 2. Proverbs. Okay. So this is what you're supposed to do this year in 2021. It says what? Commit your activities to the Lord. Let's read it together. 1, 2, go. Commit your activities to the Lord and your plans will be what? Achieved. I see your plans being achieved in 2021 in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every plan that you have set out for you will achieve it this year in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for somebody here. You are beginning to look as if your bones are weak. It's like your bones are weak, but I see God giving you supernatural strength this year.
Amen.
You will go farther than what you have in mind this year. In the name of Jesus. There's somebody here. You feel weak. Somebody's feeling weak in this place. But I'm about to let you. I'm telling you now that God has already empowered you to move forward. So it says, commit your activities to the Lord and your plans will be what? Achieved. Take me to King James. Let's read it in King James. All of us will read it together again. KJV. All right, it says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be what? Established. Let's read it one more time. One, two, go. Commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. Your thoughts shall be established in 2021. Amen. Your goals, you shall meet your goals this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet. And as you rise, lift your hands up. 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 I pray for everyone that is here that 2021 will be a year that your life will move forward in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Your friends will see you and begin to wonder this 2021. Amen. Say that amen, Wello.
Amen.
Your friends will see you and begin to wonder in 2021.
Amen.
The glory of God will go before you. It will go behind you.
Amen.
It will go around you.
Amen.
No plan of the wicked shall befall you.
Amen.
No plan of the enemy will stand against you.
Amen.
They shall come in one way, but they shall flee in what? In seven different ways. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I see you moving forward.
Amen.
I see you seeing your way clearly.
Amen.
I see you preparing effectively.
Amen.
In 2021. Come on, jam those hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah.